Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino video tutorial. In this video, we are going to take a first look at this big LCD display and we are going to build a temperature and humidity monitor with it. Let's start! I always wanted to find out a display similar to the display my 3D printer uses because it is big and inexpensive, so it can be very useful for many projects. After looking around, I discovered that the display my printer uses is this one, a big 3.2-inch display with the ST7920 driver and a resolution of 128x64 pixels. Cool! As you can see, it is much bigger than most of the displays we were using so far in our project, so it will be very useful in many future projects. It only costs around $7 and you can find a link to it in the description of the video below. Let's now see how to use it with Arduino. I am going to use an Arduino Uno today, but it works with many Arduino boards. The display uses the SPI interface to communicate with the microcontroller, so we need to connect it to the hardware SPI pins of the Arduino board. As you can see, the display has many pins to connect, but don't worry, we don't need to connect all these pins, just 9 of them and only 4 of them to the digital pins of the Arduino Uno board. The first pin, which is ground, goes to Arduino ground. The second pin, which is VCC, goes to the Arduino 5V output. RS pin goes to digital pin 10, RW pin goes to digital pin 11, E pin goes to digital pin 13, PSB pin goes to ground, reset pin goes to digital pin 8, BLA goes to the 3.3V output of the Arduino Uno, and the BLK pin goes to ground. That's it! Our display is ready to use. We can make our life easier if we hardwire all the ground pins of the display together. Now, let's see the software we need to drive this display. I am going to use the U8G library to drive this display. First of all, let's install the library. We open the Arduino IDE and from the menu we select Sketch, Include Library, Manage Library and we search for the U8G2 library. We select it and we press Install. That's it, our library is ready to use. Now let's go to File, Examples and from the examples provided with the library, let's run the graphics test example. We only need to make one change to the sketch before uploading it to the board. Since the UAG library supports many displays, we have to select the appropriate constructor for our display. So we search the code for ST7920 and from the available constructors, we select to use the hardware SPI1. We uncomment this line, like this, and we are ready to upload the sketch to the Arduino. After a few seconds, the sketch is up and running. If you can't see anything at the display, you have to adjust the contrast of the display using this small potentiometer, which is located at the back of the display. Now let's watch the demo for a few seconds. As you can see, this example sketch demonstrates the capabilities of the library and of the display. We can achieve some cool animations with this display. It is quite capable. That's why it is used in so many 3D printers. Let's now build something useful. Let's connect a DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor to the Arduino. We only need power and a signal wire which I connected to digital pin 7. To make things easier, I have also used a small breadboard. You can find the schematic diagram in a link in the description of the video below. As you can see, the project is working fine and it displays the temperature and the humidity in real time. Let's now take a quick look at the code of the project. With just 60 lines of code, we can build a project like this. How cool is that? All we need to do to use the display is to use this constructor, initialize the display in the setup function, and then all we do is to draw the frames and the strings for temperature and the humidity. The last thing we have to do is to read the temperature and the humidity from the sensor and display the readings on the screen as well. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As a final thought, I think this display is very useful in projects where we need a big display and we don't need color. It is inexpensive and easy to use. I think I am going to use it in some future projects. I would love to know your opinion about this display. What kind of applications do you think they will benefit from a display like this one? Thank you very much for your ideas and for watching the video. I'll see you next time.